So we've talked about trim in this longitudinal sense, longitudinal trim for this simplified model. Now let's talk about stability. And stability, we only have one axis that we're concerned about. That's the pitch axis. So we're going to talk about pitch stability. So let's just look at this simplified model again. We had a main wing and a horizontal all lying along some fuselage reference line. And those are relative to some CG location. And what we'd like to have happen is if we get some disturbance, let's say an angle of attack. So let's say we get a positive angle of attack that pitches our nose up. What we'd like to happen is for there to be a negative pitching moment on about the center of gravity that would then pitch our nose back down to get rid of that angle of attack. So we always want to seek the angle of attack that trims us out. And if we get a disturbance that increases that angle of attack, we want it to return to a lower angle of attack. If the disturbance decreases our angle of attack, then we want it to pitch the nose up to increase the angle of attack back to where it was, to our trim angle of attack. So the way we write that is that we want the change in pitching moment with respect to alpha to be less than zero. And we've talked about this before, but this is our pitch stability derivative. We want that to be true. So let's look at our pitching moment equation. And I'm going to plug in our pitching moment equation, as I write it this time, I'm going to plug in the values for how the pitching moment depends on angle of attack and elevator deflection. Okay, so our pitching moment in general can be written as the pitching moment of the main wing plus SH over SW, C bar H over C bar W, eta sub H times CM naught. So this is the, H naught. That's the pitching moment on a horizontal without deflection plus CM H delta E, how that changes with elevator deflection, minus L sub W over C bar W, CL wing alpha times alpha plus alpha naught wing minus alpha lift naught wing. Okay, so that's how the main wing affects the pitching moment. And then we also have the horizontal stabilizers. So this is minus L sub H over, C bar W times SH over SW times eta H CLH alpha times alpha plus alpha naught H. So that's the mounting angle minus the zero lift angle of attack with the horizontal minus epsilon D naught minus epsilon D alpha times alpha plus epsilon E times delta E. And this whole thing has to be equal to zero for us to be trim, right? So that's our pitch equation, our pitching moment equation, that all has to sum to zero. Okay, so let's take the first derivative of this, Cm alpha, the change in pitching moment with respect to alpha about the center of gravity. And of course, this equation is about the center of gravity. So we just want to take the derivative of this with respect to alpha. And that's pretty simple. It turns out that the first term here doesn't matter because the pitching moment on the main wing, that's the pitching moment at the aerodynamic center of the main wing, right? And that doesn't change with angle of attack. And for small changes in angle of attack, the location of that also doesn't change. And so we're going to assume that the derivative of the first term there with respect to alpha is zero. We can look at the same thing for this next term. It doesn't have an alpha in it. The only term that might be a function of angle of attack is the pitching moment with zero elevator deflection. And same story. So the pitching moment is about the aerodynamic center of the horizontal, and that does not change with angle of attack. So that term drops out as well. So we're doing pretty good. Let's see, this next term does have an angle of attack in it. You can see that right there. So we're going to get minus LW over C bar wing, CL wing alpha. So that's the derivative of that term with respect to angle of attack. And then finally, the last term is minus L sub H C bar W SH over SW times eta H CLH alpha. And then We actually have two alphas inside of this. We've got one right there, and then we've got an alpha times an epsilon d alpha. So when we take the derivative with respect to alpha, what we get is 1 minus epsilon d alpha. Okay, so that's our pitch stability derivative. And in order for this to be stable, that needs to be less than 0. So let's look at the terms inside of this for just a minute. So the lift slope, well, let's just go through each of these. So C bar of the wing is going to be positive. Lift slope of the wing is going to be positive. L sub H is going to be positive. This will be positive, positive, positive. Eta sub H is positive. The lift slope on the horizontal is positive. And epsilon D alpha will also be positive. Okay, so what we notice here is that the now epsilon d alpha is positive, but always less than 1. Okay, so this whole term, I guess I should say, is positive inside of here. Okay, so what we notice immediately is that all of the terms here in the second term are going to be positive, and so because that's got a negative in front of it, that means that our horizontal stabilizer is contributing to the stability of this aircraft unconditionally. Okay, it will always contribute to the stability of the aircraft. We need this this whole thing to be less than 0, and this term here, because it's got a negative in front of it, will always be less than 0. So the horizontal always contributes to stability, and so that's actually why we call it a horizontal stabilizer, because it's contributing to stability. Now the main wing depends. So these two terms of the main wing are positive. If the main wing is behind the center of gravity, meaning that L sub W is positive, then it also is a stabilizing surface. Okay, so as I've drawn it here with the main wing behind the horizontal, that is stabilizing. That means L sub W here is positive. Now, if that were negative, if we had placed the main wing in front of the center of gravity, then the main wing can be destabilizing. And that's okay as long as this term here is larger than the magnitude of this term. So we can still have a stable aircraft even with the horizontal, the main wing in front of the center of gravity, as long as the horizontal stabilizer here is strong enough, you know, as long as this term is large enough. Okay, so that's one thing we learn. So in general, one takeaway here is that lifting surfaces behind the center of gravity are stabilizing. Lifting surfaces in front of the center of gravity are destabilizing. And we're going to see that that's true once we go to lateral conditions as well. Of course, we're just looking at longitudinal for right now. So that's one thing to note out of this. Another thing to note is this term right here. This guy right here. So you notice that in the numerator, when we multiply those two together, we get a volume. So we have a length times an area, and that gives us a volume. In the denominator here, we also have a length times an area, and so that is also a volume. This term right here is what's called the tail volume ratio. And you can see that in order to increase the stability coming from the horizontal tail, we could keep it the same size and move it further back. And by moving it further back, we would be increasing this L sub H portion, right? Now the terms in the denominator are constant, or they're related to the main wing, so they're not affected by where the horizontal is or how big it is. So these terms are constant, but the terms in the numerator we can change. We can change the location of the horizontal or the size of the horizontal, and those multiply together to give us some volume, and the ratio of that volume to the volume of the main wing is what's called this tail volume ratio. So we can increase the stability or decrease it by moving the horizontal forward or aft, or by changing the size of the horizontal. That's that S sub H term there, increasing the area. So those are a couple of the takeaways from pitch stability here. And one last thing that I want to mention is that because Because an aircraft will be unconditionally stable if the center of gravity is in front of the main wing, a lot of times for the first flight, you actually want to load it so that the center of gravity is in front of the main wing, or very close to the quarter-chord or the aerodynamic center of the main wing. And that's just kind of a precautionary thing. Even if you've predicted that you can have the aerodynamic the center of gravity just a little bit behind the main wing or the aerodynamic center of the main wing, for first flights, you usually want to err on having the CG further forward, because that will increase your pitch stability. And then as you get to know the aircraft, you can slowly move the center of gravity back. And we'll talk more about the effects of the location of the the center of gravity relative to these lifting surfaces in the coming videos.